And now the man who knows that no matter who the guest is, the show is always about him, the host of WinFunnel, Deano Bravo.
I am entertaining, and I know what viewers like you want. Been behind the wheel of a race car, been underneath the race car turning the wrenches. I've been on both sides of this desk. I've been behind the camera, I've been in front of the camera, and I will bring 30 years of motorsports journalism to you in your living room. Hey, the WinFunnel, welcome. I am Deano Bravo, and this is the WinFunnel. Great to have you aboard here this evening. We are joined on this edition of the WinFunnel by the driver who won the first race of the 2007-2008 HO Champ Car season. He's a former HO Indy 500 winner, currently sits fifth in the championship standings. The driver of the McDonald's Team Spirit number zero, none other than Chris Spirit. Chris, welcome to the WinFunnel.
Thank you. I've waited a long time to be on the show.
Well, it's good to have you.
I'm excited.
Say, it's interesting to look at the current point standings here in the HOCC. And as you might expect, the usual suspects, you know, you've got Iverson, Rodder, Walczak, Margetta, you know, same old, usual suspects. But then they're sitting in the fifth spot, yourself still in contention. Your thoughts about the championship chase as we head into the meat of the HOCC schedule?
I don't know, man. I've been doing this a long time,
Yeah?
It's like my life. 9th year or something, you know.
It is. Like Bloomer?
Board, you know, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Late Bloomer, I hope so. I mean, if I don't start doing well now, I mean, it's just hanging up, I guess.
Well, it is good to see you up on that in that top five there. And perhaps we can see you move up a little more.
I hope so.
Good, good. Now, of course, you drive the McDonald's car in the HOCC. The driver of the McDonald's car on the full-scale Champ Car Circuit has moved on and will be moving on to Formula One. That leaves the obvious question, will you follow Sebastian Bourdais and move into the HO Formula One circuit?
Well, that would be fun, you know, I don't know, you know, a lot of money in that series, I heard.
Yeah.
A lot of pressure. I don't know.
What do you think he could do with all that money?
I don't know, it could be,
that'd be good. Speaking of food,
look at that cake.
We have a lovely cake here.
No, look at I like the job he's doing with the powdered sugar.
That is lovely, isn't it?
But stay away from those grapes. That one's a real
thing. Yeah, kind of squishy. Well, as always, here on the WinFunnel, email lines and phone lines are open. Give us a call, 800-555-WIN, or email us at bravo@winfunnel.net. In fact, we have an email from a viewer for you, Chris. This this comes to us from Andy in Franklin, Wisconsin. it goes, Chris, I have to ask you about being teamed up with your dad on the HOCC. Is your back tired? Because it appears to me that you've been carrying this team for a number of years.
Yeah, but he pays the bills. I mean, he owns the team. I really can't
badmouth
him.
I mean,
he'll fire me.
I thought that worked,
eh? Yeah, I mean, he's so wealthy.
You had been asked before, if you could win one HOCC race, which one would it be? Your answer, the Mini Milwaukee Mile. A few weeks back, you went and you won that race, and I was surprised, nay, shocked by your winning reaction. Let's roll it. We got the tape? Let's roll that tape. Let's look at this reaction.
Oh, Chris, congratulations!
Thank you.
What happened? Are you turning over a new leaf this season?
We'll see. I mean, it's only the first race. We'll see.
For God's sakes, it looks like we just woke you up from a coma. Now I'm going to give you another chance to give us a Milwaukee Mile victory lane reaction here on the funnel.
Okay.
Let's see it.
It's kind of hard to do. I need some buildup. I don't know.
Well, let's say, okay. All right. Here we go. We're in the winding second down in the Mini Milwaukee Mile, and Chris Spirit, he's going to score his first win in a couple of seasons, and it's right here at the Mini Milwaukee Mile. Chris Spirit, the winner. Woo!
Should have a bottle of water and
woo!
I would have played someone right in the kitchen.
You know how this works. I ask the question, quick question. You give me quick answer. We get through as many of these as we can in 30 seconds. All right.
My best.
Batman or Robin?
Batman.
Chicago White Sox or Chicago Cubs?
The White Sox.
Italian sausage or bratwurst?
Bratwurst from Milwaukee.
Pabst Blue Ribbon or red, white, and blue?
I'm more red, white, and blue than Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Really? All right. Sports Illustrated or Sporting News?
Sporting News.
Snickers or Milky Way?
Snickers.
Odd or even? And finally, Catwoman or Wonder Woman?
Catwoman.
Hey,
leather outfit. Leather outfit, leather suit.
Meow, meow. Bad kitty. He's Chris Spirit. I am Deano Bravo, and you are the race fan paying the bills. This is HOCC TV, the Wind Funnel.
It's Thanksgiving time. That can only mean one thing. It's time for the Model Empire Turkey Trot on Greenfield Avenue in West Dallas. Of course, that Model Empire.
Great place.
Great place. And, you know, it's race number 6 of the season. 5 previous races, 5 winners. Will that streak continue tonight?
Good shot. You look at the contenders that still have yet to win. Larry Rotter, can he end that 27 winless streak?
Seven.
Mike Fitzloff. Tom Spirit. You know, and
how about Amy Butler?
If Amy gets the right car, she can pull off anything. We've seen it before.
It could be 6 for 6. There's a unique aspect about this race. Of course, the traditional way, it's a D-slot race. You're only allowed so many offs and before you have to park it.
Yeah, three D-slots in the heat and 4 in the finals. You know, it's car control is what this one really comes down to.
That's right. And you know what else it comes down to? The winner of this race, of course, in tradition with the Thanksgiving turkey, gets the turkey courtesy of Model Empire. They're racing for turkey tonight in St. Francis, Wisconsin at the South Shore Speedway Road Course. Starting grid for the Model Empire Turkey Trot here at the South Shore Super Speedway Road Course, and on the pole, familiar face, Mark Walczak, looking to get the point lead back. He hasn't finished worse than second at this track in 3 previous races. He's your pole sitter, car 22. Familiar car, but a different driver. Driving the green 34 car this week, it's Mike Fitzloff. RJ Foyt, he scrapped that ride and jumped in Dean Strome's old ride he ran last week. He's the green 34, Mike Fitzloff.
Hey, wait a minute, that car's 34 too. Now I'm really confused. I think my brain's smoking. But that's Dean Strome in that car. Something called
French.
Something called Oh, yeah, that guy with the long hair, that sissy boy. He's got Juniper. I don't know what that is. But there's a champion. He's number one. He couldn't find his car before. He thought it was someone. I don't know. Jim Harrison.
Back here in row 3, you're looking at, that's not Larry Rotter, that's the fastest car in the team, that's Amy Butler again in the car 14, qualifying inside of row 3, alongside of her, the 2 car, Tom Spirit, the boiler, back behind the seat after 2 weeks off.
Hey, someone told me Larry Rotter hadn't won a race in 27 years, is that true?
Yeah, I think so, 27 centuries.
Well, there he is, in that number 4 car, and next to him, that's not Dan Margetta, that's Mike Kristoff, the fastest car on that team.
What's going on here? It's like the bizarro world here at South Shore. We're back to reality. This is the Barbie car. That's Andy Spirit. He's back in the pack in the pink and black and silver car. An awesome-looking machine at that. Here is Chris Spirit. He finished third last week in the McDonald's car.
And there's the hometown guy in the back there. They are booing him before. They're throwing beer cans at the track. That's Dan Margetta.
What a field for the Turkey Trot tonight. It's the Model Empire Turkey Trot, and it's next here on HOCC TV.
All right, it's heat race number 1. You've got Dan Margetta, a hometown favorite, lined up in this one, along with Jim Iverson, also Mike Fitzloff, and Larry Rotter. First lap is led there by Mike, followed by Larry Rotter, and then it's Dan and Jim. Pretty good lead being opened up here by Mike Fitzloff, way out front, over an entire straightaway here. And he's got second place of Dan Margetta now. He's moved up ahead of Larry Rotter. And Iverson continues to run in fourth place. Now, the thing to remember in this race is it is a D-slot race, and that means that every time your car goes out of that slot right there, that means you have been counted one of three D-slots that you're allowed. On the third D-slot, you are out of the race, and we are told that Larry Rotter has one, and now there's one for Dan Margetta. So a stop-and-go is coming up for Dan. He will park it for 5 seconds. That's the penalty for leaving any part of the track surface. Larry Rotter has struggled all season, and now tonight he has had his second D-slot. He's on D-slot watch right now. That's the black car right there. One more D-slot, and his night has been run. It's a brutal, unforgiving format, this D-slot format. Oh, we have some celebrities in the crowd tonight watching from the next to last turnover in that sitting on the couch. That's right. Beavis and Butthead have joined us here on the south side. All right. Just a moment ago, Dan Margetta scored his second D-slot. So now he is on D-slot watch, and was he in? Was he in or out? Oh, he was out. That was it. Dan Margetta just D-slotted just before the end of the first half. He's done. The hometown favorite is out of this race.
Hey, Beavis and Butthead are here. You know that?
Yeah, I saw that. That's pretty cool. Yeah, great.
How do you feel about the fact that you crashed?
Not real good. The car was junk all night. As soon as I got in it, couldn't turn. That teammate of mine, he keeps crying about bad equipment, and they figured this is a go slow type of race. It suits his style. They gave him the best ride tonight. I got stuck with the junk, so we'll take it.
I'm going to talk to Beavis and Butthead, so I'll talk to you later.
I like them Beavis and Butthead guys.
All right, now a second member of this heat race that's left is now on D-slot watch, and that would be Jim Iverson. He's running second, about three or four laps down to Mike Fitzloff. Now seven laps. That lead is just widening as we go. Almost two laps for every one that Jim is running right now. And Dan, Tommy, Kendall, all Jim Iverson needs now is laps because he wants to score that transfer.
Yeah, he's the master of that transfer spot this year so far. He's got it like the last three races, and he's down for the two count right now. We keep trying to count three on him, and it's not. His foot's on the ropes every time, and they have to break the count, and he's barely hanging on here in this heat race. But Larry Rotter's closing in.
Now, Larry has had two quick D-slots early in the first half, but ever since then has run very clean and has been catching up. And there he's going to go right by. Oh, he's now five down to Iverson. Oh, he stalled the car on the track. The car is stalled. In the meantime, he's waiting for... That car has got a transmission problem, perhaps an electrical problem, but there's no forward motion here. And now, depending on how much time is left, there's a possibility that second place could go to Larry Rotter. And if he does that, then Larry will be advancing, or at least have the ability to at least be in position for that transfer spot. Oh, there's just a few seconds left.
10 seconds.
10 seconds left. Here comes Larry. Go by him again. Larry could score at least one more lap on him. Nope, time's going to run down right now. But that car is not advancing. Even if he does make the final, will he have any power to qualify? A one-lap victory for Jim Iverson over Larry Rotter. In the meantime, Fitzloff safely into the final. And the car all bundled up full of grass and whatnot, debris on the track.
Race number two, Mike Christoph, Tom Spirit, Dean Strome, and Amy Butler set to go. There's the start. They are off. It looks like it is Tom Spirit and Dean Strome, 1-2 after lap number one, followed closely by Amy Butler and Mike Christoph. There he is back there. Dean Strome has had his second off, has fallen to second place, but he's on the death watch right now. He only has one more. This blue and yellow, or blue and white car, a brand new car in the circuit, is looking plenty fast, but he's got to keep it on the track here.
You know what, Dan, Tommy, Kendall, we talked about it in the open. Amy Butler gets a good car. Watch out for her. She's trouble. Here she is leading this heat.
Under a minute now to go, and with a pretty substantial lead, about a two or three lap lead over Dean Strome. Strom is back here racing with Mike Christoph, and it looks like Strom is going to take the transfer spot away from Jim Iverson, so it looks like the top two in points will not make the final. The shakeup is on. Mark Walczak is looking to go back out in front after missing a week ago. It could be the story tonight as Walczak's been blistering fast. He's coming up in heat race number three. But right now, heat race number two is going to belong to Waukesha, Wisconsin's Amy Butler, who has put the thing in victory lane.
It's the final heat race, and we've got Mark Walczak, your pole sitter, Andy Spirit, oh, and a D-slot on the first turn for your pole sitter. Mark Walczak just put it onto the, went straight where the, if that were the oval track, when we raced the HO Indy 500, of course, you would go straight at that point. Mark, not realizing that, did go straight. We're watching Mark Walczak, and he's right behind Chris or Andy Spirit. And Andy bumped wheels, and it caused Mark to have a D-slot in the first half. He's now got two D-slots, and he leads this heat by about two laps right now. Two, Andy. But he's scared to death to pass him. Look at this.
He's deathly afraid.
What kind of racer doesn't want to pass a guy?
A wussy racer. Kitty Bo Peep will tell you about that.
Let me tell you. Hi, Kitty Bo Peep here. Let me tell you what kind of racer that is. That's a racer who buys new shoes all the time. You should see his shoes. They're immaculate. He buys new shoes all the time.
Back after missing the last race at Lake Country Motorplex. And, you know, it's funny that we were just talking about how he was afraid to pass Andy Spirit. We also think he missed the Lake Country race because he's scared of Fat Tony DeFalco.
Yeah, he's scared of a lot of people, I think. That's what I heard. It's scared Mark Walczak. And it's not even Halloween. That's fast.
Although, you know, there could be the argument that a frightened man runs faster. So, you know, who knows?
Yeah, it could be. Or it just could be that he's, he's, what do you say when somebody's afraid to do anything? Coward?
Chicken.
But
we're racing for turkeys tonight.
That's right. Andy Spirit has just de-slotted his way. He's out. He de-slotted out. He put in a real good effort, though. Gave the fans something to cheer for. They were really hoping he would have put it in the final, but it's not going to happen.
Hi, Kitty Bo Peep here with Andy Spirit. Andy, you parked your car.
Yeah, too many offs, I guess, so I'm out.
Well, you were doing a fine job trying to rattle.
I heard some noises in the background. They're kind of distracting you, so I didn't know what was going on.
Was it the chickens?
Well, it might have been.
Did you know that Mark Walczak's favorite song is the chicken dance?
Really? Well, I'd like to see him do it.
Wouldn't that be a sight? Well,
it would be.
Well, I'm sorry to say that you parked your car. Better luck next time, Andy.
Thank you.
Holds on to take the third and final heat race. The pole sitter is in the final.
So, Amy, if you win this race, is it going to be as exciting as your first time? You know, nothing like your first time. Kitty remembers what that was like. Not racing-wise, though. So, if you win this race, is it going to be just as exciting, or is it more like a been there, done that? Well, you know, a little bit is a been there, done that, but it's still exciting. You know, anytime you beat a bunch of guys in a room, that's always satisfying to me. Well, best of luck to you, and let's hope you score one for the girls.
Are you here? Where am I?
It's ridiculous. I'll talk to you later. Okay, bye.
Hi. Dean, are you there?
Yo, I'm here. Yeah. What the heck happened to your eyes?
They say I got a syndrome with my eyes.
Wow. Bad cataract. You look like hell.
Yeah, I can't see you, but I hear you. So I'm gonna just hold this microphone over here, and I'm gonna ask you some questions.
You got a face for radio.
So how are you gonna do?
I hate this track.
Well, you made the final. You must not hate it too bad.
Oh, just dumb luck. Even a blind squirrel finds a nut once in a while.
Hey,
well, maybe.
Hey.
Well, no offense. I'm sorry.
They say my sight might come back with some experimental surgery.
Well, good luck on that.
Yeah, they say I have the little orphan Andy syndrome.
Really?
Yeah. Big talk before the race was six races. Could it be six faces in the victory lane? This is the best shot to have it happen. Mike Fitzloff, you're in the final. Looking pretty strong tonight.
Oh, thanks, Danny. We got a good car. We wrecked ours in practice pretty bad, so we got a backup from the Conquest team.
Yeah, new colors.
Oh, thing is a sweet ride.
Can you handle Mark Walczak?
Oh, yeah.
Piece of cake?
Piece of cake.
What's your strategy? How do you rattle that guy?
Just stay right with them.
Hey, what are you reading there?
Excuse me.
Hey.
Hey, Jim, make sure you got those spotters up there for me.
Hey! What are you... What's going on here? What's going on here?
Get this crew out of here.
Lovely, hey, what's going on?
I don't know.
Excuse me, it's before
hey.
Away. She's got a
hey.
Quiet time.
Hey!
Please.
They're not... They're going to fire me if I don't
Please.
Talk to them.
I'll get a couple of them here, Jim. Don't worry about
hey.
It.
Hey! So,
I held your door to my sign.
I heard some of those guys saying they were going to beat you. What's the story?
Who knows? Anything could happen in racing. You know, I had two quick D slots, contact racing incidents with Andy, and I had to take it easy just to make the finals. You know, the best thing for me is, you know, points leader Margetta finishes last, so regardless of what I do, he's behind me now.
You know, I got my eyesight back in a miracle, and I
really?
Think you
How
can...
Really?
I had a syndrome, but since I got my eyesight back, I think anything can happen today. You might win this race, I think.
We're going to give it a shot. You know, I had quickest car on the pole, but, you know, Mike and Amy are really going to be tough tonight, so... And you know, we got our third car sort of in there with Dean Strom, so anything can happen. We'll find out.
Well, good luck, and watch out for that sign.
The final of the Model Empire Turkey Trot. Ready to roll off. You've met the drivers. Let's see what happens on the first turn. Last time, Mark Walczak went off on the very first turn. He had a slow start. Big jump for Amy. She's out front, being chased, and almost caught by Dean. Oh, and then a spin right away for Dean Strom with one D slot. Kept it on the track, though. But only four D slots in this 20-minute final. Of course, we'll have pit stops, all the usual excitement of a big final race. All right, we're coming up on the halfway point of this Model Empire Turkey Trot, the 15th annual Turkey Trot. And Mike Fitzloff leads. Of course, we're coming up on the halfway point. That's when we have pit stops. Pit stops are decided by a deck of cards, sorted and then cut. And then each pit stop is decided by what's on those cards. And one of those cards includes the death card. So even though you're winning, the sword of Damocles hangs over you.
Who?
Professor here is going to explain the sword of Damocles.
Well, the sword of Damocles, educated people like to spice up their conversation with metaphors. Metaphors and symbols. And one of the metaphors is the sword of Damocles, very similar to the rock of Sisyphus, which is also very extremely similar to the anvil of Wile E. Coyote that falls out of the sky and kills you at the least opportune moment. So that's what we mean by sword of Damocles.
Thank you, Professor. It's a one-lap lead right now for Amy Butler, who has her third D slot. Next one will put her out. In the meantime, Mark Walczak is closing.
Pressure on her.
Yeah, there's definitely going to be a chase down here for second place. Of course, Walczak definitely in the championship hunt. He needs every point that he can gather. So second place would make a big difference for him as he battles with his own teammate, Jim Iverson, who did not make this final, as well as the other, our points leader going into this race, who is Dan Margetta. Dan finished dead last. And it looks like at this point, Mark has passed. Mark has gone by and is now running in second place. Our leader is now down to his last D slot. Next one would put him out while he leads. He's got about 1 minute left, and in the meantime, he's got about a 15-lap lead. It would seem unlikely unless Mike makes the final mistake. 17 laps for Mike Fitzloff, looking to become our sixth different winner in six races already this season. I don't believe this has ever happened before. We'll have to check back. This is the 15th season. This may be the first time this has ever happened. And there it is. Mike Fitzloff hangs on to win the Model Empire Turkey Trot.
Hi, Kitty Bo Peep here with Mike Fitzloff. Mike, I haven't interviewed you in a long time. Congratulations. Wow.
Hello.
And who would be so special as
Mike,
to...
Mike!
Oh,
it's R.J. Foyt.
It's that redneck...
Hey, R.J., we did it.
Low life.
Sorry, Miss Kitty. I had to take the call from the boss.
You really should stay away from him. He is nothing but trouble.
He pays good, and we got some good cars. A little assist from Conquest today, but there was some R.J. Foyt in there with the hammers. And
he's a worm.
We did good. I'm very happy.
Well.
We had a good race.
Oh, are you done now?
Yes.
Okay, well, let's move on.
I'm never done.
Let's introduce Dan Margetta, who's got the winning turkey.
Hey, it's 6-for-6. Good job, Mike. Keep the streak alive. It's a turkey. You're not a turkey, but you won one.
All right.
Yeah, you turkey.
Thank you very much, Dan.
Thanks, Model Empire.
That's right. Yes, thank you, Alex.
That looks like a good turkey.
Butterball.
Oh. You're going to invite Kitty, aren't you?
Always.
Oh, well.
Who's going to cook it?
We're going to... Hello, not Kitty.
There'll be enough heat.
Well, we'll see you next time at Bayside. And, oh, that's always an exciting race for Kitty. Oh, you never know what's going to happen there.